looking everywhere, looking everywhere, looking everywhere.
Jump Street, King Street, Bay Street, Queen Street. Jump Street, King Street,
Bay Street, Queen Street.
Jump Street, King Street,
Bay Street, Queen Street. Looking everywhere, looking everywhere. Looking everywhere, looking everywhere.
Well, I think my whole being has been tuned to sound for so many years that I can't dispose of it. I mean, I have to write something because it's pushing me. And it doesn't take much to spark me into another work.
Weinzweig was browsing the internet not too long ago when he was struck by its randomness. He was inspired to impose a musical order on the high-tech chaos.
Well, it's called Netscapes, and it's for solo piano. And I imagined that I was browsing along the internet, and I came across these rather interesting fragments of music. And they have no relationship between them. And what I would do, since they're only 3-4 bars long, each one would be played 3 times, and then I would go on to the next one.
On one level, John has spent a great deal of time involved with committee work on behalf of the interests of Canadian composers, meeting with government agencies, publishers, all the rest, representing the composer.
I think John is a very effective voice for Canadian music. I think he is effective now at this stage of his career simply because the people he speaks to know that he is not someone who can be ignored. When John speaks, he speaks with the weight of authority, of knowledge, and someone who was there in the beginning. And he knows about Canadian music and the development of Canadian music. He knows where it's been, he knows where it is now, and I would be willing to bet he knows where it's going. Because he'll make it go there.
I think it's going to be a world of many voices. And that's healthy, actually. It's the continuous openness and the influx of other ideas that actually helps to keep the music alive, and that will be so in this country.
John, of course, ultimately, as a composer, has created a body of works which I think can stand on their own internationally, and this is a very important contribution to music in this country. And of course, I feel John has an individuality which I recognize, which I enjoy tremendously, as a matter of fact. And serious music, if you will, as entertainment, pleasure, insight, experience, are provided in his works.
Harvard Collegiate John Weinzweig played on the school's hockey team. A team photo from 1932 shows he was already a big guy. But all season long, all he did was warm the bench as a substitute defenseman, until the semifinal game. That's when the coach finally sent him out, only to have John dump the opposition's star forward. John was assessed a major penalty, and that was the end of his hockey career. Still, when he reflects on a lifelong effort on behalf of Canada's composers and on his own legacy of compositions, he sounds more like a hockey player than the Dean of Canadian Music.
I'm satisfied that the music I wrote was the best I could do, and I was allowed to give my best shot.
Check, check, number 9 clears it. Work it up the left side.